ኢየሱስ ይባረክ።
Jesus be blessed.
ሰላም ለእናንተ ይሁን።
Greetings to you all.
እግዚአብሔርን በጣም አመሰግናለሁ።
I praise God greatly.
ኢየሱስ ይባረክ።
Blessed be Jesus.
ከአንደኛ ሳሙኤል ምዕራፍ 15 ጀምሬ የእግዚአብሔርን ቃል አካፍላችኋለሁ። አንደኛ ሳሙኤል ምዕራፍ 15 መነሻ ቃል ይሆንና
If I could take you to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 15 as our beginning scripture and I'll be sharing you from the word of God.
15 ቁጥር 22 ላይ
1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 22
ሳሙኤልም በሆኑ የእግዚአብሔርን ቃል በመስማት ደስ እንደሚለው እግዚአብሔር በሚቃጠልና በሚታረድ መስዋዕት ደስ ይለዋልን? እነሆ መታዘዝ ከመስዋዕት ማዳመጥም ያውራ በክስብ ከማቅረብ ይበልጣል።
Verse 22 And Samuel said, Has the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice and to hearken than that of the fat of rams.
መታዘዝ ይበልጣል የሚል መልእክት አቀርባለሁ።
So I will be presenting to you a message which says to obey is better.
እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን.
Praise be our God.
መታዘዝ በጣም ትልቅ ነገር ነው.
To obey is a great thing.
እኛ ለእግዚአብሔር ልናደርግለት ከምንፈልገው በላይ መታዘዛችን እግዚአብሔርን ደስ ያሰኘዋል።
More than the desire that we have in our heart that we want to do for God, if I could do this or that, more than our desires, our obedience is greater to God.
Amen.
Amen.
ዛላይ በጣም እግዚአብሔር የመታዘዛችንን ነገር ከሌላው ሁሉ በላይ አድርጎ ያየዋል።
More than any other thing that we could do or that we desire for God, more than anything for God the greatest thing is our obedience
መታዘዝ
to obey
ለመዳን
for ours
ለመዳን ድኖ በእግዚአብሔር ቤት ለመኖር ለማገልገል ለመባረክ መታዘዝ ወሳኝ ነው
so it is crucial our obedience is crucial for us to be saved and then to dwell in the house of God and to be used in the house of God for all of that our obedience is the primary thing
ሰዎች ላለመታዘዝ የሚፈተኑበት ሁኔታ አለ
there are situations that people get tempted to not obey
ከእግዚአብሔር በሚደረግላቸው መልካም ስጦታ ምክንያት ላለመታዘዝ ይታለላሉ።
Sometimes people they get deceived to not obey anymore because of the gift of God that is given to them.
በጣም እዚህ ላይ ሰዎችን የሚያታልል ነገር አለበት።
So in this area there's something very deceitful.
ለዚህም እንደ ምሳሌ በማቴዎስ ወንጌል ምዕራፍ 7 ላይ ያለውን ቃል ማየት ጥሩ ነው።
It is good for this to use the word to look at the word in Matthew chapter 7 as an example to us all.
ማቴዎስ ምዕራፍ 7 ላይ ቁጥር 21 ላይ ምንድነው የሚለው? በሰማያት ያለውን የአባቴን ፈቃድ የሚያደርግ እንጂ ጌታ ሆይ የሚለኝ ሁሉ መንግሥተ ሰማያት የሚገባ አይደለም። በዚያን ቀን ብዙዎች ጌታ ሆይ በስምህ እንቢት አልተናገርንምን? በስምህ አጋንንትን አላወጣንምን? በስምህስ ብዙ ተአምራት አላደረግንምን? ይሉኛል። የዚያን ጊዜም ከቶ አላወቋችሁም እናንተ አመጸኞች ከኔ ራቁ ብዬ እመሰክርባችኋለሁ ይላል ከቁጥር 21 እስከ 23
Matthew chapter 7 from verse 21 to 23 Not everyone that says unto me Lord Lord shall enter into the kingdom of heaven but he that does the will of my father which is in heaven Many will say to me in that day Lord Lord have we not prophesied in thy name and in thy name have cast out devils and in thy name done many wonderful works and then will I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Now here you see two things being compared.
አንደኛው
on one side
እግዚአብሔር ለሰዎች የሰጣቸው ስጦታ ነው.
On one side we see the gift that God has given to people.
ተአምራቱ ትንቢቱ የተለያዩ ከእግዚአብሔር የሚወርዱ ስጦታዎችን ባንድ ወገን ታያላችሁ.
On one side you see the gift that God has given, the miracle, the wondrous acts, you see that gift.
እነዛን ስጦታዎች የተቀበሉ ሰዎች እግዚአብሔርን እንደታዘዙትና ሌላ ነገር ፈጽሞ እንደማያስፈልጋቸው እንዲያስቡ ይፈትናቸዋል.
So those gifts that those people have received from God, right? The prophecy, the healing, the miracles, those gifts, sometimes those gifts might deceive them into thinking that they don't need any more obedience from God.
እግዚአብሔር already ተቀብሎኛል ብለው ድምድም እንዲያረጉ ያረጋቸዋል እና ከዚያም በኋላ መታዘዝ የሚባለው ነገር እስኪረሱት ድረስ ያደርሳቸዋልና በቀላሉ መታለል አለ.
So that gift of God that they have received, it tempts them to conclude in their hearts that God has already accepted them and they don't need to obey anymore because they have the gift.
ስለዚህ ከእግዚአብሔር የተቀበልነው ነገር ብዙ መልካም ነገር እኛን ላለመታዘዝ ሊያታልለን አይገባ.
Therefore, this is to say that all the good gifts that we have received from God should not deceive us or should not tempt us to not obey God anymore.
ይሄንንም ሳረገው ወዲያው የእንዶ በቃ እኔን እንዶ ለኔ ያደላን እኮ የሚመስለኝ በሚል እሳቤ በሚል ሐሳብ ማግኘታችን ከእግዚአብሔር ማግኘታችን የተለያየ ስጦታዎች ማግኘታችን ለእግዚአብሔር ለመታዘዝ እንዳያታልለን.
Don't let that thought get conceived in your heart, that seed that says, God must have loved me. Whatever I pray, God just gives me that right away, right? So God must love me. And then don't let that thought make you think that I will not obey God anymore. Don't do that.
እግዚአብሔር የተመሰገነ ይሁን.
Praise be our God.
ለእግዚአብሔርም የምናደርገው ነገር ልናደርግ የምናስበው ነገር እንደ ሳኦል አሁን ሊያደርግ ያስበው ነገር መታዘዝን ሊተካ አይችልም.
Or even look at Saul, for example. He had things that he wanted to do to God which were contrary from what God wanted. That shouldn't also deceive us to go in a different direction, even if it looks like a good thing.
መታዘዝ ከሁሉ ይበልጣል.
To obey is greater than anything.
ከእግዚአብሔር ከምንቀበለው ለእግዚአብሔር ልናደርግ ከምናስበው በላይ መታዘዝ ይበልጣል.
To obey is greater than what we have received from God, and also to obey is greater than what we want to do to God, for God.
እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን.
Praise be God.
እስቲ ወደ አንድ ቃል ወሰዳችሁ.
Let me take you to one scripture.
ዕብራውያን ምዕራፍ 5 ላይ
Hebrews chapter 5
ቁጥር 8 ላይ
verse 8
ስለ ክርስቶስ የተነገረ አንድ ቃል አለ.
There's a word here spoken about Christ.
ምዕራፍ 5
chapter 5
ቁጥር 8 ላይ
verse 8
ምንም ልጅ ቢሆን ከተቀበለው መከራ መታዘዝን ተማረ ከተፈጸመም በኋላ በእግዚአብሔር እንደ መልከጼዴቅ ሹመት ሊቀ ካህናት ተብሎ ስለተጠራ ለሚታዘዙለት ሁሉ የዘላለም መዳን ምክንያት ሆነላቸው.
Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8, though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered, and being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him, called of God and high priest after the order of Melchizedek, of whom we have many things to say and hard to be uttered, seeing ye are dull of hearing.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
ሁለት ነገሮችን እዚህ ጋር እንመልከት.
Let us look at two things here.
ምንም ልጅ ቢሆን የሚል ቃል አለ.
There's a word that we've read, it says, which said, though he were a son.
ልጅነት አለ ልጅነት መብትን ነው የሚያሳየው መታዘዝ ባርነትን ነው የሚያሳየው
So to be a son we can understand to be a son is it gives us some kind of a freedom to be as we want right because we're a son but to obey signifies some form of
servanthood yeah ስለዚህ ባንድ በኩል ባለመብት ሆነን ኢየሱስን አባታችን ስንል ሌላውን ነገራችንን እንዳንረሳ ባሮችንን ልጅምነን ባለመብትነን እንደገና ደግሞ ባሮችንን በመታዘዝ በኩል ባሪያዎችንን እግዚአብሔርን በማዘዝ በኩል ልጆችንን ስለዚህ በማዘዝና በመታዘዝ መሐከል የቆምን ሰዎችንን እግዚአብሔርን በመታዘዝ ባሪያዎችንን እግዚአብሔርን በሚያስፈልገን ነገር ደግሞ በማዘዝ ልጆችንን ስለዚህ እኛ ሃይብሪድ ነን የባሪያና የልጅ
we are like a hybrid because we have two things when it comes to our identity to God one we are children so as children we have privilege to act like a child to ask for this or that to command God give me this God give me that right we have that privilege as a child but on the other side remember we are also servants and as a servant we're also supposed to obey so we are two things
hallelujah
hallelujah
ስለዚህ አሁን የልጅነቱን ነገር ልተውና ምክንያቱም የልጅነቱ ነገር መቼም እንደሚያሳብዳችሁ ስለማቅ አንዴ ብድግ ቁጭ አርጎ መዝሙርም ያስወጣችኋልና አንድ ጊዜ የመታዘዙን ፓርት እንድናገር ፈቀዱልኛ
So if you allow me let me just focus for now on the side of the servanthood I know as a child you're going to get excited you're going to want to jump and everything because as a child you have privilege but for now let us focus on the obedience and the servanthood
እግዚአብሔር ይባረክ
Praise be our God
Hallelujah
Hallelujah
ይሄንን አሁንም በእግዚአብሔር ቃል እንደው ትንሽ አይን ገለጥ ለማድረግ እንዲመች አንዴ ገላትያ ምዕራፍ 4 ላይ ልወሰዳችሁ
Let us just supplement this with the word of God of what we have just heard if I could take you to Galatians chapter 3
No 4
Galatians chapter 4
ቁጥር 1 እና 2ን ብቻ አነባለሁ
I'll be reading verse 1 and 2 only
ምን ይላል ነገር ግን እላለሁ ወራሹ ህፃን ሆኖ ባለበት ዘመን ሁሉ ምንም የሁሉ ጌታ ቢሆን ከቶ ከባሪያ አይለይም ነገር ግን አባቱስ ከቀጠረለት ቀን ድረስ ከጠባቂዎችና ከመጋቢዎች በታች ነው የሚል ቃል አለ
Galatians chapter 4 verse 1 Now I say that the heir as long as he is a child differs nothing from a servant though he be lord of all but is understood but is under tutors and governors until the time appointed of the father
እዚጋ ወራሹ ህፃን ሆኖ ባለበት ዘመን ሁሉ ምንም የሁሉ ጌታ ቢሆን እንደ ልጅ ምንም የሁሉ ጌታ ቢሆን እስከ ቀጠረለት ድረስ አንድ ሊማር የሚገባው የልጅነት መብቱ ላይ ከመሽከርከሩ በፊት አንድ ሊማር የሚገባው ህይወት ውስጥ ይገባል ያም የምንድነው የባርነት ህይወት ውስጥ ይገባል የመታዘዝ ህይወት ውስጥ ይገባል እግዚአብሔር ልጆቹን በመታዘዝ ውስጥ አሳልፎ ነው ወደ መብት የሚወስደው ሃሌሉያ
So what we can understand from this is that before God leads his children into the life of to be an heir before we are led to that part of our life to be an heir to have that privilege before that we have to go through that refinement of servanthood so that we may learn
obedience
and so through that filter we would learn obedience and then after that we will be taken into being an heir
ልጅነ ወራሽ ባሪያ አይወርስም
because the child is an heir but the servant is not an heir
ግን ልጁ ወራሽ እንዲሆን መጀመሪያ በባርነት ውስጥ ያሳልፈዋል ልጅ መሆኑን ሳይክድ ልጅ መሆኑን ሳይሰርዝበት ልጅ ነህ ነገር ግን በመታዘዝ ውስጥ አልፈህ ባርነትህን አረጋግተህ ዘን ልጅ አርጌ አወርሳለሁ ይላል እያንዳንዳችን የእግዚአብሔርን ቃል ኪዳን የመብዛት በሉት የመባረክ በሉት ቃል ኪዳን ከመሬት ተነስተን ከኢየሱስ ተወልጃለሁ ብለን ብልክ ብለን ወደ ወራሽነት አንሄድም ወራሽነት ጋር እንደርሳለን ግን በምን አልፈን ነው በመታዘዝ በኩል አልፈን መታዘዛችንን ልክ ሲያበቃ እግዚአብሔር ወደ ወራሽነት ክልል ውስጥ ያስገባናል
we have to go through servanthood first think of it as maybe as a filter we have to go through that servanthood before we start to claim our rights as a child it still remains the fact that you are a child of god but first you have to go through the servanthood so that is to say before we start to say I am a child of god so we will multiply god will bless us before that first we have to go through that servanthood
bezab obedience
So God requires that we go through that obedience.
መታዘዝ የሚባለውን ነገር ካልተለማመድነውና መታዘዝን ልጅ ሆነን ከጠላነው ወደ ውርስ ጋር አንደርስም
As a child we
ስለዚህ ወራሽ መሆን የምትፈልጉ ለምን ልጆች ከሆነን ምን ደውጭ ነን ወራሽ መሆን ግን አውቶማቲካሊ ልጅ እንደሆንክ የሚመጣ ነገር ሳይሆን ልጅ ሆነህ መታዘዙ ስትካለፍክ በኋላ then ወራሽ ትሆናለህ ስለዚህ አጉል ልጅ ነኝና እኔ ወርሳለሁ ብትል አይሆንም ወራሽ ከሆንክ መጀመሪያ በባርነት ውስጥ አልፈህ ከዚያም በኋላ ቪዛ ተመቶልህ በባርነት በኩል አልፏል በመታዘዝ በኩል አልፏል ስትባል አሁን ልጅ ነህ ወራሽ ነህ
so the requirement of god is that as a child as a son as a daughter it's still required of us to obey even though we're an heir we still have to obey if we start despising obedience as a child that is trouble because of that before we get to that being a child first we have to go through that filter or think of it as a visa stamp first we have to learn to obey
yeah.
as a servant and then after you pass that test after you can obey then you got your stamp now you're a child
ልክ እንደሱ ነው የሚለው ይሄንን እኛም በእኛ ህይወት ውስጥ እንደሚከናወን ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ ለማሳየት ምን አደረገ ምንም ልጅ ቢሆን ከተቀበለው መከራ መታዘዝን ተማር ከተፈጸመም በኋላ ምኑ ከተፈጸመ በኋላ መታዘዙ ከተፈጸመ በኋላ እስከ ምን ድረስ ነው ያውም የታዘዘው እስከ ሞት ድረስ የታዘዘውን ያ በጣም ዲፕ የሆነ መታዘዝ ነው ያንን ካለፈ በኋላ እንደመልከ ጸደቅ ካህን ብሎ ተሾመ ይላል እቺ ቤተ ክርስቲያን መሾም የምትችለው አንተ መሾም የምትችለው ለውርስ መሾም የምትችለው ልጅ ነህ ግን በምን አልፈህ ነው በመታዘዝ ውስጥ አልፈህ ነው ይህ ከተፈጸመ በኋላ እንደ መልከ ጸደቅ ሹመት ለዘላለም ካህን ብሎ እግዚአብሔር ማለት ይላል ሃሌሉያ ስለዚህ ነገሮቻችን የተቆለ አሁን ሁላችንም በኢየሱስም ስንጠመቅ በመንፈስ ቅዱስ ስንሞላ ልጆች ስለመሆናችን አልቋል ተረጋግቷል አሁን እየቀረ ያለው ወራሽነት ጋር ለመدرس እየቀረብን ያለው ነገር ምንድነው የምናልፍበት የመታዘዝ ህይወት ያንን የመታዘዝ ህይወት ካለፍነውና ከፈጸምነው እግዚአብሔር ልጆች የሚባሉ የእግዚአብሔር ልጆች የሚባሉ ሊወርሱት ያለው ነገር በሙሉ እንዳለ የተለቀቀ አንዱን ሳታመስግኑ ሌላው አንዱን ማመስግናችሁ ሳትጨርሱ ሌላው አንዱን አመስግናችሁ ሳትጨርሱ ሌላው እየተረባረበ ይመጣል ሃሌሉያ ግን ያችን ማለፈን ኦክ
So that's why what we've read right about Christ right it said though he was a son right though he was a son he had to obey and not only obey he had to obey even unto death right so after he went through all of that then he was called as a Melchizedek as a high priest forever right he got appointed now he became an heir so in that same way for me and you when we got baptized right when we got filled by the holy spirit we are already marked as a child right but in order to be an heir there's still one more test. We have to learn obedience. After we pass that, then we become heirs.
Samtachual?
Have you heard?
Samtachual way.
Have you heard it?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን ስለዚህ ነው መታዘዝ ይበልጣል የሚለው መታዘዝ ትልቅ ቦታ አለው.
That is why the word of God tells us, as we've read, right? To obey is better. That obedience has the greatest of places.
እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን.
Praise be our God.
የልጅነት ነገር በመታዘዝ ውስጥ ካላለፈ እንደውም ግራ ሊገባችሁ ይችላል ልትሰናከሉ ትችላላችሁ እንዴት ነው ልጅ ሆኜ ነው የእግዚአብሔር ልጅ ሆኜ ይሄ ሁሉ ነገር ለምንድን ነው እኔ የማይሆንልኝ የሚል ጥያቄ ናላችሁን አዞሮ ጭንቅላታችሁን አሽከርክሮ እግዚአብሔር እኔን ባይወደኝ ነው ምናምን ብለን የምንቀባጥርበት ነገር ውስጥ ልንገባ እንችላለን ኖ ኖ ልጅ ሆነህ ይሆናል ግን ልጅ ሆነህ በመታዘዝ ውስጥ ማለፍ አለብህ እሱን ስትጨርስ ነው የልጅነትህ መብት የሚከበረው
as a child it is very crucial it's important that we learn to obey without that we could even fall we could even be led astray and be misunderstood because we start to think I'm a child, right? Why is this happening in my life? I'm a child. Does not God love me? Right? That's a temptation. So we have to learn, right? First, we have to go through that obedience of no matter what. After that, then your privilege or your right as an heir, as a child, will start to get honored. But first, you have to learn obedience.
እንዲያውም አሁን እኛውን በተለያየ አይነት መስቀልቀል ባለ ህይወት ውስጥ ስናልፍ
even sometimes in our life when we go through a season of our life which is kind of chaotic what do we start to say
getaw ine lije hadellum
we start to say lord am I not your son am I not your daughter
or demo tikkelenya yalhone bota no nde gebiche ni yalhone emnet ust gebiche no nde ni lije neny iyalku mfokra
or am I in the wrong faith thinking that I'm your child am I in the wrong faith
bilen ጥያቄ ምልክት ይፈጠርብናል
and then that question mark could be conceived in our hearts
የሆነ እዛ ጋ ትንሽ ይሄ እንደ ጊታር ምናምን ትንሽ ቲዩን ላርጋችሁ
so on that area let me help you let me tune you as a guitar let me help you
መጽሐፍ ቅዱስ የሚለው እዚህ ጋ ስለ ክርስቶስ ምሳሌያችን ስለሆነ ከተቀበለው ከተቀበለው መከራ አጎረመረመ ልጅነቱን ዳውት አረገ ከተቀበለው መከራ ነቃና ምን ተማረ መታዘዝን ተማረ ስለዚህ የተቀበላቸው መከራዎች እኛን ሊሰጡ ዲዛይን የተደረጉት ምን ሊሰጡን ነው መታዘዝን ሊያስተምሩን ዲዛይን የተደረጉ ናቸው ልክሱን ስንጨርስ እንወጣለን እንደገና ተመልሰን ሃሌሉያ በቃ ድክምክም ካልንበት እንደ ባሪያ ከተከረከምንበት እንደገና we come out to act like a child of God እንደዛ ነው የሚሆነው ያለው እንጂ ያ መከራው ዲዛይን የሆነው ለምንድን ነው ለመታዘዝ ነው እግዚአብሔር ይባረክ እንጂ እኔ እግዚአብሔር ልጅ አይደለሁም እኛን እንድንል አይደለም እንድንማር ነው ምን መታዘዝ
Amen. The scripture that we've read, right? Christ is our perfect example for this. As it said, what does it say? Because of the suffering that he has received, it says, right? He learned obedience. That's what it says, right? So in the same way, that suffering that we go through, think of it as maybe as an incubation, right? You're like you're in this shell, you're right? Until you learn obedience. After you learn that obedience, then you come out of the shell and you earn your right as a child.
Ara hallelujah belu.
Say hallelujah.
Ara hallelujah belu.
Hallelujah.
ስለዚህ እያንዳንዱ ከዛሬ ጀምሮ የምናልፍበት ነገር ሁሉ እግዚአብሔርን question የምናደርገው ሳይሆን ምንም እንማርበት ነው መታዘዝን የምንማርበት ነው ምን የምንማርበት ነው መታዘዝን የምንማርበት ነው ስለዚህ ዛሬ ለሰይጣን ቦታ አንሰጥም እግዚአብሔርንም የምንከስበት እግዚአብሔርንም question የምናደርግበት ምንም መንገድ አይኖርም ሃሌሉያ ሃሌሉያ እግዚአብሔር ይባረክ
praise be our god so what we are going through whatever suffering that we go through in our life right it is not for us to learn disobedience can you say with me it is not for us to learn disobedience but rather it is for us to learn obedience
complainer mndin hon aidellem
it is also not so that we may become complainers of god
egziaberin tiyaqe ustin lenasgeba adellem
it is not so that we start to question our god
ya emnetachinenim tiyaqe ust lemasgeba adellem
it is not so that we start to question our faith
lijinnetachin tiyaqe ust megbaratum aidellem
it is not so that we start to question if we're a child
ምን እንደምንማር ነው
but what is it for us to learn
ታዘዝን እንድንማር
but rather it is so that we learn to obey
hallelujah
hallelujah
እግዚአብሔር ይባረክ
blessed be our god
እንግዲህ መታዘዝ
obedience
እሺ ማለት አሜን ማለት ላይ ብቻ አያበቃ
and you know obedience doesn't start and end by saying yes okay it doesn't
ባሜን አያልቅም
it doesn't end obedience does not end with amen
በሱን ምንገላገላችሁ እንዳይመስላችሁ
don't you think that you're going to get a break by just saying amen it's not easy
እናዚያውን ቸርች ቁጭ ብላችሁ አሜን ሃሌሉያ ስላላችሁ ስብከት ላይ ኦ ሃሌሉያ ታዘዋል አይባልም
just because
አቹ ያንን አሜን ያላችሁበት ነገር ስታደርጉት ምን ይሆናል መታዘዝ ይባላል
just because you are here listening to the word of god and you say amen or hallelujah that doesn't mean that you are obeying you have to go out into the world and act on what you have said amen to then your obedience is confirmed
allachu
are you with me
yollachu amen ayalkum
it doesn't end with amen
aun saul hidinna malekawyanen atfa wendunum setunum atfa blo ሲጠየቅ ሲነገረው ሲሰበክ እዩ እብድ ያለ እልልታና አሜን ነው አሜንን እልል ብሎ ይሄደው
when Saul the king Saul was given the commandment or think of it as he was preached to right to go to obey and destroy all of the Amalekites right he must have been dancing and jumping saying amen I'm going to do it hallelujah
hallelujah ብሎ ወጥቶ
But he said hallelujah and then he went out but when he arrived at the place
እነዚ የማይረቡትን ከሲታ ከብቶች ምኖች ሁሉ ካጠፋ በኋላ
after he destroyed all of the skinny cattle
ከዚያ እንዲሚያማምሩ ከብቶች በጎች አየ ማለት
after he destroyed the skinny ones now he saw the fatty rams the fatty cattle
ነሱን ሲያይ
when he saw them
and gize geta yesu chinqillate embark balu si
once just say lord bless my mind just say that bless my mind lord
bagziaber balu
let me beg you just lay your hands and say lord bless my mind
amro yenbark
bless my mind hallelujah
lemen endesu alkwachu mesela
do you know why I'm asking you to do that
bagziaber hulu gize yihone neger siyaz amroachin degmo lela neger yazallena
because whenever god commands us to do one thing our mind gives another commandment
na enten logic jemere indi enezi ko ahon balatafacho legziaber mesuat aqarbachawallo
so his mind got activated started to think new logic and said you know if I don't destroy the fatty ones I can bring them to god and I can start offering them to god from the mind
እግዚአብሔር እንዴት ይሄንን ነገር ጠፋው ወይ ድንገት ቢዚ ሆኖ ይሆን
maybe started thinking how is it that god missed that maybe god was a little too busy so I'm going to spare those ones
ከዚያ የተወሰኑትን ምንድነው ስሙ አስቀርቶ አመጣ
so he spared those fatty cattle and he brought them back
ያኔ ነው ቀድም የጀመርኩላችሁ እንደመነሻ የጀመርኩላችሁ ጥክስ አንተ መታዘዝ ከመስዋዕት እኮ ይበልጣል የተባለው ያን ጊዜ
That is why the first scripture that I read to you to obey is better than sacrifice that's when that scripture comes to shine
ስለዚህ መታዘዝ አሜን ላይ የሚያቆም ሳይሆን አክሽን ላይ ነው የሚተገበረው
Therefore obedience does not end by saying amen but rather on action
ብዙ አሜኖች አሳልፈናል ቸርች ውስጥ
In church we have gone through many amens
ብዙ እልልታዎች ጎሮሯችሁ እስኪነቃ እናቶች እግዚአብሔር ይባርካችሁ እልል ብላችኋል
Mothers may God bless you you have gone through many joyful shouts until your throat run dry
አሁን ግን ከአሜንና ከሃሌሉያ ተሻግረን
But now we should pass over from amen and hallelujah to
ወደ መታዘዝ ውስጥ መግባት አለብን
We have to pass over
አለበለዚያ ለልጅነታችን ልንወርሰው ያለውን ነገር እናስቆያለን ምክንያቱም እግዚአብሔር ሁልጊዜ መታዘዝ ጋር ካልደረስን ወደ ወርስ አያመጣንምና
So now the time has come. We have to start to pass over from amen and hallelujah to obedience and to start taking action. Unless we start to do that, our rights, our privilege, our blessing as a child, we start to get delayed. We start to miss out. So it's better we start acting.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Atfrunji, amen balu.
Don't be afraid. Say amen.
እኔ እንዲሁ በአሜን ልኑር በቃ ቸርች እየመጣሁ አሜን ልበል ሌላውን ነገር እግዚአብሔር ይያል እንኑር ወይንስ እንድፈረው ለመታዘዝ እንድፈር
is it better for us to just choose to just come to church and just say amen and then go back home or should we start to dare and to start obeying and acting on the will of God
ቀደም አምሮአችን ለእጃችንን ጭነን ጌታ ሆይ አምሮዬን ባርክ እንበል አላልኩ
earlier did I not say let us lay our hands on our mind and ask God to bless our mind
ለምን መሰላችሁ
you know why
አምሮአችን ሁልጊዜ ለእግዚአብሔር እንዳንታዘዝ ጠላታችን ይሆናል
the reason is our mind always becomes the enemy for us to disobey God
ወደ ሁለተኛ ቆሮንቶስ ምዕራፍ 10 አንዴ ልወሰዳችሁ
let me take you to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10
ሁለተኛ ቆሮንቶስ ምዕራፍ 10
2 Corinthians chapter 10
ከሶስት ጀምርና አነባለሁ
I'll start reading from verse 3
በሰው ለማድ ምንም እንኳን የምንመላለስ ብንሆን እንደ ሰው ለማድ አንዋጋም የጦርቃችን ስጋዊ አይደለምና ምሽግን ለመስበር ግን በእግዚአብሔር ፊት ብርቱ ነው የሰውንም ሐሳብ በእግዚአብሔርም ዕውቀት ላይ የሚነሳውን ከፍ ያለውን ነገር ሁሉ እናፈርሳለን ለክርስቶስም ለመታዘዝ አንዴ አሜን በሉ እስቲ ለክርስቶስ ለመታዘዝ ምን እናደርጋለን እሺ አሁን ታዘዙ ብላል ወንድም ደጉ ለክርስቶስ ለመታዘዝ ምን እናደርጋለን ለሚለው ለክርስቶስ ለመታዘዝ አምሮን ሁሉ እንማርካለን ታዘዛችሁም በተጸመች ጊዜ አለመታዘዝን ሁሉ ለነበቀል ተዘጋይተናል
አሜን 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3 for though we walk in the flesh we do not war after the flesh for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ and having in readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled so it says here what do we need to do to
we bring our thoughts and captives
yes bringing this is the emphasis bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ
hallelujah እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን
praise be our God
ስለዚህ አመራችን የሚያፈልቃቸው ሐሳቦች አሉ።
So this is to say our mind has thoughts that it brings forth.
እና ሁልጊዜ ወደ እግዚአብሔርን ወደ አለመታዘዝ ውስጥ ነው የሚከተን ከለቀቀ ነው።
So our mind has it's like our mind has a will of its own and if we set it loose the thoughts that come out of our mind will lead us into disobedience of God.
ስለዚ ምን ማርከው የምናስረው እጅ ወደ ኋላ የምንለው የራሳችንን ጭንቅላት ነው.
So our focus or our target is on the mind. Who do we need to capture, or who do we need to say raise your hands or hands behind your back? It's not somebody else, it's your own mind.
It's not even devil,
it's not even the devil.
And then to zari satanunum,
even today Satan, leave him alone.
Lananta nom sabko inji le satan adellem sabko.
I'm preaching to you, not to Satan.
Selezi እግዚአብሔርን እንዳንታዘዝ የሚያደርገን ምንድነው? አምሮአችን ነው. ካምሮአችን የሚወጣ ሐሳብ ነው. ያንን እንማርካለን. ሃሌሉያ. እንማርካለንና ከዚያ እንዲታዘዝ እናረጋዋል. እንደውም እንዲታዘዝ ብቻ አይደለም, ያልታዘዘበትን ዘመን እንዲበቀልና ሁለት ጥፍ እንዲታዘዝ እናደርጋዋለን ነው የሚለው.
So the question is, who is leading us to disobey? Who is responsible? Who is the troublemaker? It's our own mind. Therefore, the thoughts of our mind, we will lead it captive. We will capture it. But not only capture it, we will avenge our own mind for the times that we have spent disobeying God. We will even make up for it and serve our God. Brothers, what do you see through this? What did we learn earlier about opening our eyes? What do you see from that?
ምን ትረዳላችሁ?
What do you understand?
ስለዚህ ሁልጊዜ እግዚአብሔርን የምንታዘዘው ተሰምቶን ብቻ አይደለም, ወይንም ደግሞ ፊሊንጋችን ኦኬ ብሎን አይደለም, ሐሳባችን ዋው ብሎ አይደለም. ሐሳባችን ዋው ባይልም ልክ ይገባል. ታዘዛችሁ? አውነት እናንተ የራሳችሁን አምሮ ለማሰር ይጨክናላችሁ? ዛሬ ሰይጣንን ብላችሁ በደንብ ነው በያዘዘም እንትሉ, የራሳችሁን አምሮ ግን አስራችሁ ካፕቲቭ ለማድረግና የእግዚአብሔርን ፈቃድ እንዲፈጽም ለማድረግ ዛሬ ተወስናላችሁ.
I mean, here's the thing about your mind, right?
ወታደር መሆን ማለት ይሄ ነው. የክርስቶስ ወታደር ነኝ ብሎ ሰይጣንን እግዚአብሔር የቀጠቀጠውን በመስቀል ላይ ያጠፋውን ሰይጣን እናንተ ናችሁ, እኔ ነኝ. ይሄ ጭንቅላት ነው ለእግዚአብሔር መንግስት አደጋው. ስለዚህ እሱ ነው ዛሬ የእግዚአብሔር ልጆች ማርከው ሃሌሉያ ለእግዚአብሔር እንዲታዘዝ የሚያደርጉት. ይሄ ነው ጀግንነት ማለት, ይሄ ነው ጉብዝና ማለት, ይሄ ነው ለእግዚአብሔር መሰጠት ማለት.
Amen. And here's the thing, the biggest enemy is your own mind. It's your own mind. And here's the thing, to act, to obey is not about your feeling, because your mind, you might hear one commandment from God and your mind might say, yes, that makes sense, I'm going to do it. Amen, right? But on another occasion, you're given a commandment and your mind might say, no, I don't want to do it, I don't feel like it, I don't feel comfortable, right? It's not about your feeling.
Uh-huh.
It's about the commandment. So whether you feel like it or not, you have to do it. That is obedience. And then on top of it, right, leave Satan alone. You are a soldier of God, you're a warrior, right?
Uh-huh.
So as a soldier, as a warrior,
uh-huh,
you go and fight.
Uh-huh.
You go and fight and you have to overcome.
የጦር መሳሪያችን ስጋዊ አይደለም የተባለለት ከባድ መሳሪያ ማለት ይሄንን አንደር ሰብጀክሽን ሊያመጣ የሚችል የእግዚአብሔር ጸጋ በእያንዳንዳችሁ ላይ ይሁን.
So the armor of God, each and every one of you, you have the grace, that you have the grace of God that can leave your own mind captive and obey God.
ምንድነው የሚለው ሮሜ ምዕራፍ 12 ላይ ሲናገር ምንድነው? እንግዲህ ወንድሞች ሆይ ሰውነታችሁን ያውና ቅዱስ መስዋዕት አድርጋችሁ ታቀርቡ ዘንድ በእግዚአብሔር ርኅራኄ እለምናችኋል, እርሱም ለአምሮ የሚመች አገልግሎታችሁ ነው. የእግዚአብሔርን ፈቃድ ታውቁ ዘንድ በአምሮአችሁ መታደስ ተለወጡ እንጂ ይህን ዓለም አትምሰሉ. የጋ ነው ለውጥ መፈጠር ያለበት. ካም ኦን, እዚህ ጋ ነው. ሃሌሉያ ሃሌሉያ. ዛሬ የእግዚአብሔር ቃል ሃሌሉያ የእግዚአብሔር መሳሪያ ሁሉ የኛን አስብ መማረክ ከቻለ ስለ ሰይጣን እኔ ግዴለኝ ለምን በኤፍራጥስ ያሉ አጋንንት አይወጡ ለምን እንደ በየአገሩ ያለ የታሰረ አጋንንት ለመጨረሻው ዘመን የታሰረ አጋንንት አይወጣም አይ ዶንት ማይንድ አባውት ዛት ይሄስ ከተማረከ ድረስ
Amen, amen. In the book of Romans, the word of God, it says, And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove that which is good and acceptable, the perfect will of God, which is your reasonable service. So it's not about the worst of the devil coming out. That's not the concern. The concern is our own mind and captivating it.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
ወንድሞች ሃሌሉያ
brothers hallelujah
ወንድሞች ሃሌሉያ
brothers hallelujah sisters
መታዘዝ ይበልጣል
to obey is better
መታዘዝ ይበልጣል
to obey it is better
hallelujah እግዚአብሔር ይመስገን
praise be our god
ትናንትና ወንድሞሰን የሆነ ነገር እየተናገረ ነበር
yesterday brother wasan he was telling us some things
ሁሉ ጊዜ ቦታ የለቀቀው ከኛ ህይወት ቦታ የለቀቀው ነገር በሌላ ነገር ካልተተካ አደጋ አለው የሚል ነገር እየተናገረ ነበር
Yesterday through brother Wesen we were learning about when we start to remove certain things in our life be it sin or something that empty that void area it needs to be exchanged for something else right
ይሄንን አሁን የምናገረውን ነገር ስናገር በጣም ኢሞሽናል ያረጋኝ
and what I'm about to tell you makes me deeply emotional
ቢያረጋኝም እናገራለሁ
but even that's the case I will still share it to you
እግዚአብሔር እስራኤልን ስሙኝ ታዘዙኝ እያለ በተናገረ ቁጥርና እነሱ ባመጹ ቁጥር እንደዚህ ሆነ
the number of times the many times the multiple times that God commanded the Israelites hear me and they continued
and obey me
he was saying hear me and obey me the Israelites continued to disobey
እና እንደዛ ሲያረጉ ባለመታዘዝ መቀጠል አልቻሉ listen ባለመታዘዝ ለእግዚአብሔር ባለመታዘዝ መቀጠል አልቻሉ
So they started to continue disobeying, but they couldn't continue that disobedience forever.
ለእግዚአብሔር አለመታዘዝን አልቀጠሉበት.
They couldn't continue disobedience to God.
ምን እንደሆነ ታውቃላችሁ?
Do you know what it is?
ላልሆነ መንፈስ አልፈው ተሰጡ.
Because of their disobedience, they were given up to an evil spirit.
እንዴት እንደሆነ ታውቃላችሁ?
Do you know what it is?
እግዚአብሔር ያዘቻቸውን ለሞሎክና ለፍልስጤማውያን አጋንንት ሊትራሊ ለማረድ ለዛኛው በዚህ ልክ የሚታዘዙ ሆኑ።
What God has asked them to do and to obey was a very short list, very simple thing, but they couldn't disobey and they kept on disobeying. And the result of that, the Israelites, they became obedient.
Yes.
They became, as a result of that, they became obedient to the foul spirit, even to the point of sacrificing their own children.
አሁን ይሄንን ሰው ይታዘዛል ልጅን አንገት ላይ ቢላ አርጎ በየቀኑ አንድ ሁለት እያለ ልጆቹን ወደሚሰዋበት ነገር ይታዘዛል ለምን መሰላችሁ ለእግዚአብሔር ባልታዘዙበት መጠን ለማይረባ መንፈስ አልፈው ተሰጠው እግዚአብሔር ታዘዙኝ ካላት እችን ከመታከለው ፈጽሞ ሊጠበቅ የማይችል ነገር እንዲታዘዙ አልፈው ተሰጠው አለመታዘዝ ላይ አያቆምም አንድ ሌላ ገዢ ይጠራል እንግዲያውስ እኔ ማልገዛችሁ ከሆነ እኔ ማልገዛችሁ ከሆነ ብሎ እግዚአብሔር መገዛት ውስጥ ከተናቸው
Disobedience doesn't end with disobedience as we have learned yesterday it gets replaced with something. So they were incapable to obey the short list of God's commandments. They couldn't obey that. And because of that disobedience, soon they started to become, first they started to become disobedient to God, and as a result of that, they started to become obedient to evil spirits. How could a person sacrifice their own children today, tomorrow, one after one? How could anyone do that? So something gets exchanged as a result of that. It's always like that. Let him not surrender to that spirit. Can we all stretch forth our hands?
Jesus, asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up for that, Jesus.
Jesus, asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up for that, Jesus.
Jesus, asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up for that, Jesus.
Tazzidan.
I will obey you.
Asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up.
Asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up, Jesus.
Asallifa hatist.
Don't give me up.
Asanifat.
Don't give me up.
Bemitai asanifat stay.
Because of my disobedience, don't give me up, Jesus.
Asanifat stay.
Don't give me up, Jesus.
Asanifat stay.
Don't give me up, Jesus. Asanifat
stay, Jesus. Asanifat. Chindendichwalin, Jesus. Asanifat.
We'll shout out to you. Don't give us up, Jesus.
Anay. ጻድቅ ጮኸተኝ ኢየሱስ ይስማል
አሳልፈህ አትስጠኝ
አዛልባትስ ብዙ ነገሮች መንገል ላይ አቅሩብኝ ጌታ ኢየሱስ ወደ ልጅነቴ መብት ልሻገር ጌታ ኢየሱስ ወደ ልጅነቴ መብት ወደ ውርሴ ልሻገር ጌታ ኢየሱስ ታዝዤ ወደ ውርሴ ወደ አጥቶ አዘጋጀልኝ ቃል ኪዳን ጌታ ሆይ ልሻገር Hallelujah.
Help me enter into my heir as a child. Help me to earn that right.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, la ya harala barala bash harala barala basaya. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wagenoch,
my brothers, my sisters.
ለእግዚአብሔር በመታዘዝ ላይ ሰይጣን ያስፈራራናል።
You can't do it ilalal. Satan will start to add fear. He will start to scare us when we start to think about obeying God. He will start to tell us you can't do it.
Let andesti be Jesus sim nibel.
Let us rebuke it in Jesus name.
Yewushat abat Satan be Jesus
father of lies in Jesus name.
ሊንገራችሁ
let me tell you this
ስለነ አይደለም የምንታዘዘው
we're not obeying because we have the capability or because we're capable
ማምነን የምንታዘዘው
we obey because we believe not because of our capacity
ስለነ አይደለም የምንታዘዘው ሰይጣንን ሰይጣን ውሸታም ነው ችለን እንደምንታዘዝ ያረግና አለመቻላችንን ደሞ ያመጣና ስለዚህ አንቺ አትችም አንተ አትችልም ይሄንን የማይቻለው ነገር ለሞክር ብለህ አትግደርደር ይለንና ተስፋ ያስቆርጠናል ልንገራችሁ ምስጢሩን ችለን አይደለም ለመታዘዝ እግራችንን የምንዘረጋው ምን ነው
and let amen
ምን ሆነን ነው አምነን ነው እህቶች አምነን ነው እስቲ አንድ ቃል አንብላችሁ
and we do things or we obey God because we believe I don't have the skills I can't do that that's the trick of the devil so we obey because we believe not because we're capable
ሮሜ ምዕራፍ 1 ጋር ወሰዳችሁ
let me take you to Romans chapter 1
ቁጥር 5
verse 5
በርሱም ስለ ስሙ በአሕዛብ ሁሉ መካከል ከእምነት የሚነሳ መታዘዝ እንዲገኝ ጸጋንና ሐዋርያነትን ተቀበል
Romans chapter 1 verse 5
yes
by whom we have received grace and apostleship for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name among whom are ye also the called of Jesus Christ
ስለዚህ የምንታዘዘው እምነት ነው አነሳሹ እምነት ነው
so we obey through faith faith is what activates it
ይቻላል በሉስ ያንዲ
say it's possible
በኢየሱስ ሁሉ
በኢየሱስ
ሁሉ
through Jesus all things are possible through Jesus all things are possible
ምሳሌ ልስጣችሁ
let me give you an example
Saul
saw
ዳዊት እንዲሞትለት ፈልጓል
he wanted David to die
በቃ እሱን ከአይኑ ፊት እንዲጠፋለት ፈልጓል
he just wants to remove David from his sight he just wants to destroy him
ቅናት ሞልቶበታል
he's full of jealousy
ከዚያ እንዲህ አለው
then he said this
ልጄን እድርልሃለሁ
says I will wed you to my daughter David
ነገር ግን ለልጄ ማጫ የምጠይቅህ የመቶ ፍልስጤማውያንን ሸለፈት ነው አለው
he said I will wed you my daughter remember Saul he's jealous of David and he wants to destroy him so what he said you know I'm going to wed you my daughter but as a dowry I want you to bring me the foreskin of 100 Philistines
how many are going to
why is he interested in foreskins
work out
it's not gold
gotarawstike
he doesn't store it in his barn
tabso aybalaw
he's not going to deep fry it and eat it
mendin no intention
what's his intention
in sewoch lemegdel sied yimotilnyal bulun
his intention his plan is when David goes to destroy them in the battle he will die likely
gen
however
david ishyal
however David he obeyed he said yes
ምን ለምን ይሻል
why did he say yes
ተንኮሉንም ያወቀ
even though he knew the deceit in Saul's heart
intentionንም ያወቀ
even though David knew the intentions of Saul
እኔ አምላክ አለኛልና
he said it's okay I have my God
አምኑ
and remember he believed
አያችሁ መታዘዝ ምን ቢኖ ሲኖረው ነው መሰላችሁ በጣም የሚያዝናናው እምነት ሲኖረው ነው ሃሌሉያ
so you see the thing is our obedience will give us great comfort in our heart when we have faith
ከዚያ ተነስቶ በሰነ ስርዓት ሄደ ማለት
said so after that he rose up and he went his way
ቋ አርጎ መቶውን ይዞለት ነው
so he just slew the one the second the 100 and he came back
you no በእግዚአብሔር ይልቅ ነገሩን እቺ ተንኮልናት ይሄን ዲህ ነው ምናምን ብላችሁ ቁጭ ብላችሁ ካርታ ከመትጫወቱ እዛ ላይ ነገር ከመትሩ ታዘዙ በእምነት እግዚአብሔር ይሰራል
so this is what I'm trying to tell you rather than you analyzing in your mind is this the intention is it good is it bad rather than analyzing just believe and obey and God will do his work
አረ ሃሌሉያ በሉ
can you say hallelujah
አልኳችሁ ለመታዘዝ በጣም አደገኛው ማን ነው ይሄን ካላስተራችሁ ይረብሻል ድሮ በብሉይ ኪዳን ሽጣጋል ባላችሁ
ድሮ በብሉይ ኪዳን በግ ይታረዳል
መስዋዕት አይደል ሰምታችኋል የሚታረደው ለመስዋዕት የሚታረደው በግ ዝም ብሎ አይታረድም መሰዊያ እንትኖች ማሰሪያው ሁክ አራት ሁክ አራት ሁኮች አሉ ሄዶ በጉን ያስተኙና እንዳይረብሽ ሲታረድ እንዳይረብሽ ቀንዱን እዛኛው ላይ ያስሩታል ከዚያም በኋላ በሰነ ስርዓት ቄሱ ያርዳል ይሄ ጭንቅላታችን ካልታሰረ እንረብሻለን ለመታዘዝ አንችልም የእግዚአብሔር መሰዊያ ቀንድ አለውና እዛ ላይ ታሰሩ በኢየሱስ
አሜን አሜን so let me tell you this for your obedience the problem the troublemaker it's this it's the mind and let me tell you this what happens in the old testament right in the old testament you know at least you've read or heard about how lambs were sacrificed upon the altar right so what they do in that time is you would have the altar and on the edges of the altar you would have like hooks yeah. right so they would bring the lamb to be sacrificed and as they're slaughtering the lamb so that it
before,
doesn't
before
they slaughter the lamb what they do is they tie the horn to each corner of the hook that way the lamb is not going to try to run away or give them trouble it is hanged it's not going anywhere and then they will do the slaughtering and that same way our mind is the troublemaker so we need to hang it to the hook so that it doesn't give us a problem and let me tell you this there's a hook for our mind in the word of god
ara hallelujah
hallelujah
awun abrahamen egziaber 25 amet tsalliyo yagenyeun lij sawallign yalu
and now abraham the son the child that he got after 25 years of prayer god asked him sacrifice him for me
yinnen ahun man litat
who will obey such a commandment
ጌታዬ እንደው 40 ጊዜ ቢናገርም ራሱ ወርድ እንደዚህ ብድ ቋ እግሩ እንዲ ቋ ቋ ያደረገ አብሮ ቢልም እዚህ አሁን የሚታዘዝ አይደለም እንኳን አይደለም ግን ፈታኝ ነው ግን አብርሃም እንዴት ያንን አደረገው ቢባል ሮሚ ምዕራፍ 4 ሲናገረው እምነት አደረገው እግዚአብሔር እንኳን ቢወስደው ቢሞት እንኳን ተመልሶ ያው ይሆናል ብሎ አመነ ይላል ስለዚህ ነው የሶስት ቀን መንገድ ልጁ ሲያባባው ሆዱን እንዲ ሲያረጋው ዳዲ ይያለን ትንሲለው ቀጠበሎ ይሄደበት ምክንያት ያመን ነበር የምንተዘዘው ስለምናመን ነው እንጂ ስለግዴታ አይደለም
That was a very tough commandment to obey for Abraham to sacrifice his son. Leave alone God communicating to him through a voice. Even if God himself is going to come and he's seeing God with his own sight, with his own eyes, right? It is very difficult to obey, right? But Romans chapter 4, it tells us how Abraham was able to do it. He did it in faith. He said, even if my son dies, he believed that God will resurrect him. So it's the faith.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Unet ahon bezich qal ledemdem.
Let me conclude with this word to you.
Izi church us
in this church
Dallasin chemro
including Dallas.
Malla Ethiopia ust yallu
including all the churches all over Ethiopia.
Balem yallu tebatatno yallu churches
including churches
unet bezi wengel la yallu
including churches scattered all over the world that are in this gospel in this truth.
እንደ ቤተ ክርስቲያን እንደ ግለሰብ ደግሞ ያንዳንዱ በሚሊየን የሚቆጠር የኢየሱስ ልጅ
and that's as a church and then individually each and every one of you all over the world that are a child of Christ
የቃል ኪዳን ልጅ ነው
each and every one is a child of the covenant
የቃል ኪዳን ልጅ
you are a child of the covenant
ወራሽ ነው
you are an heir they're an heir
እንደ ቤተ ክርስቲያንም
as a church
እንደ ግል አንዳንድ የእግዚአብሔር ልጅ
as a church as well as an individual each and every one of us
ምንድነው ልመናይ
this is my prayer
ልመናይ ማለት እናንተን ምለምነው
or my request to you all is
ይሄ የመውረስ ነገር አይዘግይብን አይቆይብን በዚህ በመታዘዝ ውስጥ ቶሎ እንለፈና ውርሳችን ውስጥ እንገባ እንግባብዬ እንዲሁ በእግዚአብሔር ስም ፊታችሁ ሆኜ ለምናለሁ
I want to beg you by the name of God for each and every one of you let us not delay our blessing as an heir. Let us just quickly go through that obedience and let us become the child of God and become an heir. Don't prolong it. Do not delay it.
ውርሳችንን አናዘግየው
አልኪዳናችንን
አናዘግየው መታዘዝ ይፍጥን ለመታዘዝን እንበቅል እዚያም በኋላ እግዚአብሔር በልጅ ለመላ አሜሪካ ይፈጽም ለመላ ዓለም ይፈጽም ለእያንዳንዳችሁ ኢየሱስ ይፈጽም
Let us not delay our blessing, our covenant. Let us hasten. Let us run to obey God. And then let us claim our right. Let us receive our blessing as a child, as an heir to all the churches, to Dallas, to Houston, to each and every one of us. Let us hasten to obey God and become the heir.
Six. Azamijji atnichi adillim musabkillachu. So me salliye egziabher lezich beta kristiyan yesetayn qal makab
I'm not preaching to you by just finding scriptures that are matching. No, I'm sharing you this after much fasting and much prayer, and this is the message that God has given me to you.
Someone,
please hear me.
Nishagar.
Let us pass over.
What is that? Look, worse than Nishagar.
Let us pass over into that great heir, that inheritance.
Again, unfortunately, there is no shortcut.
Unfortunately, there is no shortcut.
የግዴታ በመታዘዝ አልፈን ነው ወደዛ መንደር።
We have to pass through obedience in order to inherit. We have to go through that.
ይሄን መናገር ስለነበረብኝ.
And I have to share this to you.
ጨርሻለሁ.
I have concluded.